Let's talk about Polya's problem-solving strategy. Nearly 100 years ago, a man named George Polya designed a four-step method to solve all kinds of problems. First, understand a problem. Second, devise a plan. Third, carry out the plan. Fourth, review the solution. First step is to understand the problem. You can restate the problem in your own words for you to better understand it. You can also determine what is known about these types of problems, and if there is missing information that, if known, would allow you to solve the problem. And if there is extraneous information that is not needed to solve the problem, you have to get rid of those to avoid confusion. And most importantly, you have to know the goal why you are solving this problem. Second step is to devise a plan. Here you will be needing to make your own plan on how you can resolve the problem. Now here are some examples of plans that can be useful in solving your problems. First is to make a list of known information. Second is to make a list of information that are needed. You can also work backwards. You can also look for patterns or write an equation if necessary. You have to define what each variable represents. You can also guess the solutions and check your result. This is more likely doing a trial and error. So after devising a plan, we have to carry out our plan. Here we need to work carefully, especially to our solution. We also have to keep accurate and neat records of all our attempts. This is for us to understand and for us to realize which part we did wrong, for us to revise it, and eventually we'll get the correct solution. And we also will be needing to realize that some of our initial plans will not work and that we have to devise another plan or modify our existing plan. Last step is to review the solution. Here we have to ensure that the solution is consistent with the facts of the problem. We also have to interpret the solution in the context of the problem if it makes sense or if it is reasonable. Next is that we have to ask ourselves whether there are generalizations of the solution that could apply to another problems, or if there are another methods that would apply for us to look for the solution. Now let's try to answer this problem. The area of a square is 64 centimeters squared. What is the length of one side of the square? First step, identify the problem. Now here, we have to identify the one side of the square. Second step is to devise a plan. The area of a square is determined by the product of lengths of each side with itself. Since we know that the shape here is square, we know that all sides are equal of length. From this, we can work backwards by taking the square root of the area to find the length of the side. Now, next step is to carry out the plan. Since given in the problem that the area of the square is 64 centimeters squared, we have to get its square root. The square root of 64 squared is equal to 8. So, the length of one side of this square is 8 centimeters. Now, to get a clearer view and for us to check if we have the correct solution, given that 8 centimeters as our answer, this will be multiplied by itself to get the area of the square. 8 multiplied by 8, that is 64, exactly the same as the one that is on the problem.